Within the Azure AI Content Safety service, the default AI classifiers are sufficient for most content moderation needs. However, you might need to screen for items that are specific to your use case. You could do so by creating a block list. The block list enables you to define a list of terms for the model to consider when evaluating whether content should be blocked. I'll first run a test without a block list using a sample customer inquiry for the Contoso camping store. In the customer's inquiry, they express that an incident occurred with their camping cooker and that they'd like to know how to clean the device. Let's set the threshold levels to medium and run the test. Although the content is allowed, the severity level for violence is low. If no harm was detected, then the severity level for all categories would be safe. This result is an indication that the model detected violence at a low level within the inquiry. Let's now run the test again with a block list. A block list is created within the Use Block List tab. I'll start by creating a new block list and then providing a name and description for the list. Once the list is created, I can add terms to the list. I'll add the words kill, die, dead, and stab. With the block list now created, let's run another test to validate whether the model blocks the content. We'll leave the threshold levels set to medium. The results indicate that the content is blocked and was rejected by the block list detection. The judgment for all categories is still allowed. However, since we've now added a block list, there's a new section for block list detection, which lists the terms hit. In our case, the term die was hit. The text that was tested did not explicitly include the word die. Rather, the text included the word died. Despite using the words past tense, the model is still able to detect a term from the block list. To get started with text moderation, visit ai.azure.com.